Hello everyone, in this video we shall consider some of the commonly used laboratory animals. So we shall brief into some of the characteristic features of these animals and their use as experimental animals. So the first animal is the rat. The source or the species name is Rattus norvegicus. This is how it looks like. Now coming to some of the properties of this rat. Now usually an albino rat is quite commonly utilized because it's white in color, so it's quite suitable for most of the experimental work in pharmacology because it has a small size and it has great sensitivity towards most of the drugs. Okay, now in this type of animal, the albino rat, there are two species which are quite, or the strains which are quite commonly used, that is the Wistar rats or Sprangdoleron. So out of these two, Wistar rats are quite commonly used as an experimental animals. Okay, coming to some of the characteristics of these particular animals. Okay, so it belongs to the rodents. Okay, so and it does not vomit. Okay, because it lacks the vomiting center, does not have any vomiting center. So also it also does not have any tonsils or gallbladder also. These are also absent in the rat. And the pancreas of this particular animal is quite diffuse. Okay, so it is used for the studies related to the pancreas, okay, diabetes and all. Okay, then even the stomach, it has a characteristic feature in that it is divided into two parts with a prominent ridge. Okay, now coming to the rat as an experimental animal. So which are the experimental situations in which the rats are used? First of all, rats are quite commonly used in the testing of psychopharmacological agents like the CNS stimulant drugs or the CNS depressant drugs, antipsychotic drugs. So these are studied with the help of the rats. Okay, rats are quite commonly used. Apart from that, it is also used in the assay of different hormones for studying the estrus cycle, mating behavior and lactation. Apart from this, it is also used in study of the drugs on the blood pressure. Okay, then even this rat, okay, is used to study the gastric secretions. In that, it is having a unique property that there is a continuous secretion in the fasting animals, the fasting rat. So that's the reason why these are quite commonly used in studying the gastric secretions. Apart from this, rats are also quite commonly used in study of the analgesic property of the drugs. So drugs having analgesic property. So analgesic activity is quite commonly studied with the help of rats. Okay, with the radiant heat method, in which the tail, the heat is applied to the tail and the withdrawal time taken to withdraw the tail from the heat source is measured. Then next use is in the acute and chronic toxicity studies. Also rats are quite commonly used. Then a 24-hour-old rat, okay, just the newly born rat, which is 24-hour-old. This is physiologically similar to a 6-month-old infant. So you can use these small rats, 1-day-old rats, for studying the drugs on the infants. Okay, so evaluation of certain drugs or compounds in the infants, it can be simulated with the help of these 24-hour-old rat. Apart from this, several isolated preparations also are utilized to test the various drugs, like say for example rat uterus, it is used to study the bioassay of the oxytocin. Stomach can be used, or colon can be used for studying various spasmogenic drugs. Okay, then next animal is the mouse. The species name is Mus musculus. Now this again over here, albino mice are quite commonly used, the white colored ones. So these are the smallest laboratory animals. So these are quite small animal, easy to handle. These are cheap, and even since because their size is small, a smaller amount of drug may be required to produce a certain action. Okay, this out of this Swiss albino mouse is a quite commonly utilized strain of the albino mice. Now, mouse as an experimental animal. So, first and the very common use of this animal is in the acute toxicity study. Apart from that, assay of insulin and analgesics also utilize mouse. Okay. In the analgesics, mouse can be used for the writhing test, okay, so to study the peripherally acting analgesics. Apart from this, screening of chemotherapeutic agents, a general screening wherein you do not know the exact use of that particular drug. So the screening or the new drugs, okay, they are used, it can be screened with the help of mouse. Next use is in testing of drugs for the teratogenicity, any adverse effects in the to the fetus during the pregnancy. So this can be studied. Then one more important development of this particular experimental model, okay, in the form of nude mouse, that is a hairless mouse. So this is an experimental mouse which is it is generated with the help of removal of the thymus. Okay, so it does not have thymus, so that's the reason why it is deficient in the T lymphocytes. So so this animal model, it is quite commonly used in studying the immunity or transplantation research. Next animal is the rabbit. Okay. Oryctolagus cuniculus is the species name. Now rabbits, these are quite docile animal, these are quiet animals, okay, so they hardly make any movements, okay, so they are not quite aggressive, but they are quite docile animals if you handle them very carefully. Now out of these, the New Zealand white rabbits are quite commonly utilized as an experimental animals. Okay, now one specialty is the occurrence of the atropine esterase, the enzyme which can hydrolyze the atropine. So this is the reason why there is a decrease in the pharmacological response to atropine in the rabbits. So they are insensitive. Okay, so this property can be utilized to study certain pharmacological situations. Now coming to the rabbit as an experimental animals. The first and the very important use of this rabbits as an experimental animal is in the pyrogen testing, okay, wherein the intravenous fluids are administered, okay, and pyrogen testing is done, for which rabbits are used quite commonly. A temperature is measured. Okay, then apart from this, certain agents which can affect the capillary permeability, these can also be quite commonly studied by using rabbits by intravenous injection of these compounds to the animal. Next use of rabbits is in testing of insulin or other anti-diabetic drugs, curare or sex hormones can also be studied using rabbits. So also the skin of rabbits is quite sensitive towards the irritant, so it is used for study of the irritants or topical agents. So they are studied by using the rabbits, by application of these substances to the skin of the rabbit. So their sensitivity is tested in the rabbits. Next, rabbits are also used in the serological experiments or screening of embryotoxic agents or teratogens, those which are harmful to the fetus, okay, when administered during the pregnancy. So such testing can also be done by using rabbits. Okay, then apart from this, these animals are also used in research on the reproduction. The reason behind this is ovulation is non-spontaneous, then there is no seasonal anestrum, that is lack of mating, okay, so it is absent. Then gestation period is quite short, semen can also be easily collected. So that's the reason why these are quite commonly used in research which is related to the reproductive system. Apart from this, isolated heart or duodenum, ileum can be used to study several drugs. Next animal is the hamster. Now there are two species of hamsters which are quite commonly used as a laboratory animal. First one is the Sirian or the golden hamster, Mesocrisetes oryctus, and the second one is the Chinese hamster, that is Chrysetulus griseus is the species name. Now hamsters are again they are quite easily handled, okay, and these have a chunky body with short legs, fluffy tail. Even their body, full body, they have a loose skin and the full body is covered with dense, short and soft fur. Even they have rounded ears, and ears are usually pigmented and they are scarcely covered with the hair. Now, one prominent characteristic feature of hamster is that they have a cheek pouches which can extend up to the shoulder region, and this cheek pouch is also utilized in several experimentation. Now, hamster as an experimental animal. Now, the first use of these hamsters. Now, out of these, the golden hamsters are quite commonly used for investigation in several fields like virology, cancer and nutrition research, genetics, then pharmacology, toxicology, reproductive physiology. Then the Chinese hamsters. These are quite commonly used in research on diabetes. That's because they have a high incidence of spontaneous diabetes mellitus in this particular species. Then this species also is utilized in the parasitological investigations also. Then the Chinese hamsters, they have low chromosome number. Number of chromosomes is low as compared to the other animals. So that's the reason why these are quite commonly utilized in cytological investigations or genetics, tissue culture, radiation research. Then a cheek pouch, as I've told you earlier, the presence of cheek pouch also makes this animal unique. It can be used in the field of immunology. Okay, so also a strip cut from the pouch of golden hamster stomach, the stomach region, a strip can be cut and it can be utilized for the in vitro study, that is the in vitro assays of prostaglandin E and prostaglandin F can be carried out by using this particular animal. Next animal is the cat. Felis catus is the species name. Cats are quite commonly utilized animals, one of the carnivorous animals which are quite easily available, and these are mostly used in the studies on the circulatory system or neuromuscular system, okay, because these systems have quite closely or the close resemblance towards that of the man. Okay, apart from this, one more characteristic feature of cat is that it has highly developed nictitating membrane, the third eyelid, which is inactive in the human being. So it is quite active in the cats. So the contraction of this nictitating membrane, it can be affected by several drugs. So their effects can be studied by utilizing this property of the cats. Now, coming to the cat as an experimental animals. Okay, so most commonly cats are utilized to study the drug which are affecting the blood pressure. Next use is to carry out the assays of catecholamines, that is adrenaline, noradrenaline and all. Okay, then nictitating membrane. So the contractions of this nictitating membrane can be recorded for the investigation of drugs like ganglionic blocking drugs. Next, study of the nerve centers in the brain, okay, is done with the help of cats. Okay, apart from that, cats have the ability to produce methemoglobinemia. Okay, so that's the reason why cats are quite commonly used in toxicity studies of compounds like acetanilide. Next animal is the dog. Canis familiaris is the species name. Now, dogs, mainly mongrels or beagles, is quite commonly used. Now, these are one of the quite commonly used larger animals which are used. That's because dogs are quite friendly and they can be easily tamed and trained. Okay, so these particular animals also, they have characteristic feature which resemble to that of men, that is small stomach or short intestinal tract. So also they can be trained to carry the stomach cannula. Okay, so these are the animals of choice for studying the gastric secretions or the digestion. Now, dog is an experimental animal. Dogs are commonly used in studying the effects of drugs on the blood pressure. Okay. Then they have a discrete pancreas. So this is the reason why they are quite commonly used in studying the diabetes or the effects of drugs on the diabetes. Then chronically prepared gastric fistula and pouches. These are utilized for the study in the gastric secretion. So dogs are quite commonly used for studying the gastric secretion. Next animal is the frog. Rana tigrina is a commonly used species. Now earlier in the olden days, frogs were quite commonly used in pharmacological experiments. Okay, because of their widespread availability. Okay, and easily they could be bred. But nowadays the use of frog is banned because the species is getting extinct. So instead the simulated series are available in which the dissections or the experiments by using the rectus abdominis muscles or several other techniques may be available in the form of series. So they are utilized nowadays. Frogs are banned totally. They cannot be used. So some of the uses of frog as an experimental animal. So mostly the actions of drug on the CNS can be studied, or effects of drug on heart, neuromuscular junction is quite commonly studied in frogs. Then the diagnosis of pregnancy. Apart from this, retinal toxicity of certain drugs can also be determined. Next animal is the monkey. Now monkeys and apes, these belongs to primates. So these are the highest order of the mammals. So that resemble quite closely with that of the human beings. So that's the reason why these are generally used in the later stages of the study of any particular drug. Okay, because these animals are quite common in having a similar type of uterus as that of human beings, exhibit the regular menstrual periods. So that's the reason why these particular animals, okay, mostly monkeys, are utilized in the study of psychopharmacological agents, or metabolism in the rhesus monkey also nearly approximates to that of man. Even the sensitivity of this drug are also quite close to that of men. So just because before the clinical trials, the testing is done in the apes or the monkeys. Okay, so monkey as an experimental animal. So as I've told you earlier, the last stage of evaluation is mostly done in these particular animals just before the clinical trials, because of the quite close resemblance. Apart from this, primates are also used in the fields of virology, parasitology, then immunology, immunosuppression, nutrition, reproduction, etc. Next animal is the guinea pig. Cavia porcellus is the species name. This guinea pig is also quite commonly used laboratory animal. So these are also easily available. These are quite docile animal, okay, quite easy to maintain and raise. Okay, and one speciality is that this animal is highly sensitive to histamine. Now the uses of guinea pig as an experimental animal, first is to evaluate the bronchodilators, to study the effects of bronchodilators. So tracheal preparations may be utilized. Then also these animals are utilized in immunology, okay, particularly the delayed hypersensitivity. So also study of local anesthetic as well as bioassay of digitalis can also be carried out by utilizing the guinea pigs. Okay, then guinea pig have quite sensitive cochlea. That's the reason why it is used in the hearing study pertaining to the hearing or the pertaining to the ear. Apart from that, one more similarity of this guinea pig towards the human beings is that it requires exogenous vitamin C supply. Okay, so this is the reason why it can be used to study the ascorbic acid metabolism. Also, it is suitable host for the mycobacterial infection. So tuberculosis can be studied, or drugs affecting tuberculosis can be studied by using guinea pigs. Also, guinea pigs are also quite resembling the human beings to study the isoniazid toxicity. Okay, then various isolated preparations like ileum, tracheal chain, vas deferens can be utilized to study the effects of different drugs. So this is the reference.